Hello, today we are going to talk about the SN1 reaction mechanism. S stands for substitution, N for nucleophilic, 1 for unimolecular. Substitution. One atom or group being replaced by another atom or group is a substitution reaction. Since this replacement is taking place by a nucleophile, that is OH in this case, it is called as a nucleophilic substitution reaction. Now we need to understand as to why we are giving it the number 1, that means why are we calling it as a unimolecular reaction. We shall understand it by looking at the mechanism of this. Usually this type of reaction mechanism is undergone by those substrates wherein the carbon is overcrowded or it is surrounded by a large number of bulky groups which do not allow the nucleophile to come and attach to the carbon. If we notice, we have got 3 alkyl groups attached over here. In order to differentiate between the 3, we have put R dash, R double dash, R triple dash. This is called steric hindrance. Hence, my nucleophile cannot come and attack the carbon from this end. The other end is already occupied by the halide ion. So the first step involves creation of space for the nucleophile to come and attach. Hence, the first step, which would be slow because it is resulting from a stable neutral molecule to a charged intermediate, we have the halide ion leaving the substrate molecule to give us an intermediate over here where carbon carries a positive charge. If you notice, this is trigonal planar carbon atom having a positively charged carbon in the middle, hence it is sp2 hybridized carbon. Since it is symmetrical, the nucleophile can attack the intermediate from either ends. We differentiate by saying either the rear attack or the front attack. If the attack takes place from the back, we have the first product over here, which has a configuration opposite to that of the initial starting substrate. On the other hand, if the attack takes place from front, we will have a product which has the same configuration as that of the initial starting substrate. Experimentally, it has been observed that products with both the configurations are formed. With the result, our mixture of product is optically inactive. This is called as a racemic mixture, wherein we have equimolar proportions of both the compounds. These can be separated experimentally. Now, if you notice over here, our first step was slow. The second step resulting in the formation of stable molecules from an unstable intermediate would be fast. Hence, our first step becomes rate determining. Hence, the rate of the reaction would depend only on the concentration of the substrate. We call it as a first order reaction. Involving only one molecule, hence it's a unimolecular reaction, hence the designation SN1. And as we said earlier, the resulting product is a racemic mixture of molecules with inversion of configuration and retention of configuration. Please go through a write-up related to SN1 reaction mechanism on the site and get back to us with your doubts. We shall be happy to help you with those. Thank you.